the glorification of Vrindavan, all the residents of Vrindavan. And we're hearing about Uddhava, who had gone to Vrindavan to deliver a message from Krishna to the gopis. So Uddhava, when he, after meeting the gopis and seeing their pure love for Krishna, he glorifies the gopis. So Uddhava prayed that he would be so fortunate to take birth as one of the bushes or creepers or herbs in Vrindavan. And that way he will be able to get the dust from the lotus feet of the gopis. So Lord Krishna describes that the Vedas mainly deal with the subject of the three modes of nature. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says the Vedas only deal with the three modes of material nature. And he tells Arjuna that he should rise above the modes. So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Uddhava says that for one who has tasted the nectar of the pastimes of Lord Krishna, there's no use of taking birth as a brahmana. It doesn't do him any good to take birth as a brahmana. And even if you take birth as Lord Brahma, to take birth as Lord Brahma wouldn't be any use either. Because anyone who develops an attraction to hear the topics of Lord Krishna, then they don't need to have that kind of birth. They don't need to follow the Vedic injunctions. Vedic injunctions are there to help people regulate their thought and to control their behavior. But if somebody is in Krishna consciousness, then that's not important. So the gopis there, they don't have to do these kind of things. The only desire of the gopis is to follow the path of their beloved Krishna.
公平论的心愿就是去追随他们心爱的 Krishna 的道路。
So we could also understand Uddhava's words that it's like it's an answer to a doubt which may be there.
我们也可以这样去理解 Uddhava 的这番话，这番话是为了回应人们脑海当中的一个疑惑。
So the Vedas are worshipable even for Brahma and the other demigods. They all respect the Vedas.
甚至主 Brahma 和其他的半神人们都尊重伟达经。
They get their knowledge from the Vedas.
他们从伟达经当中获取知识。
So we hear from the Vedas, we also hear words, we also hear from the Vedas.
我们也从伟达经当中聆听伟达经的论述。
So we may wonder, how is it allowed? How is it the gopis, they don't need to hear the Vedas?
我们可能会产生疑惑。为什么这些勾品们他们就不需要去聆听伟达经了呢？
They don't even have to follow the Vedas. Why?
他们甚至连伟达经都不用去追随，那原因何在？
So Uddhava says, to answer this doubt, Uddhava says that well, the words of the Vedas are limited. They're limited.
为了回答。
They're limited to ordinary religious principles.
为了回答这个疑惑，乌德瓦说：“伟达的训谕，是仅限于普通的宗教体制。”
But the gopis have transcended all that. The gopis are far beyond ordinary religious principles.
勾品们已经超越了这个层面了，他们远远超越了普通的。宗教道德层面。
Because the gopis are beyond all that because they've taken complete shelter of Krishna.
勾品们他们远远超越了这个层面，他们全然脱离了 Krishna。
So the Vedas, they can look for Krishna. They can try to find out Krishna.But the gopis already have Krishna.
伟达经只是在努力地去寻找探索 Krishna, 但是勾品们已经获得了 Krishna.
And some people who are authorities, they say that the Upanishads have the right to become gopis.
按照某些权威的观点，这些乌帕尼夏的奥义书，他们有权利成为勾品。
Because the Upanishads, they are very eager to worship Krishna in the gopi special mood of prema. The Upanishads have that desire. They want to be like gopis and have prema.
因为奥义诸经他们拥有这样的愿望，他们渴望以勾品们的特殊的 prema 的心态来崇拜 Krishna。
But we should not accept this. We don't accept that the Upanishads can do this.
但是我们不接受这一点，我们不接受 Upanishad 的奥义诸经能够做到这些。
Because the Upanishads there, they don't have the devotion even equal to the goddess of fortune Lakshmi.
In 此他们没有资格成为勾毗。
They need to have the Krishna's special mercy before any of them can ever come to that level.
在他们任何人能达到这个层面之前，他们是需要 Krishna 的特殊仁慈。
So the goddess of fortune and Lord Brahma and all the other demigods, they have realized all their desires.
幸运女神、主 Brahma 还有其他的人，他们已经实现了自己的心愿。
And they, all of the goddess of fortune and Lord Brahma and the demigods, they're all masters of yoga perfection.
幸运女神、主 Brahma 还有所有其他的半神人们，他们都是瑜伽完美境界的主人。
And they can all worship the lotus feet of Krishna within their pure minds.
他们可以在他们纯净的心意当中崇拜 Krishna 的莲花足。
But when Krishna was dancing Rasa Lila, Krishna would embrace the gopis and he'd place his lotus feet on them. And in this way, the gopis gave up all their sorrow.
在 Rasa 之舞当中，主 Krishna 拥抱那些 gopi 们、牧牛姑娘们，而且他把他的莲花足放在他们的身躯上面。就这样，这些 gopi 们他们内心的这些苦恼也就一并消除了。
So.Devotees of Krishna, they renounce their families and whatever else they possess so they can approach Krishna.
Krishna 的奉献者放弃了弃绝了自己的家庭以及他们拥有的一切去接近 Krishna.
Of course, that's only if these things prevent them from approaching Krishna, then they will give them up.
如果这些阻止他们接近 Krishna 的话，他们就把他们放弃。
But the gopis, they surrender, their surrender makes them special.
但是勾皮们的臣服使得勾皮们是独一无二的。
Krishna's lotus feet are worshipped by the goddess of fortune.
Krishna 莲花足受到幸运女神的崇拜。
And she serves the lotus feet of Krishna by massaging them.
他通过按摩 Krishna 的莲花足来服务他。
And the goddess of fortune is always waiting on him to serve the Lord in any other way.
幸运女神总是在他的身边伺候他，以种种方式来服侍他。
And demigods like Brahma and Rudra and Indra.They also worship Krishna's lotus feet.
像 Brahma, Rudra, Indra 这样的半神人也崇拜 Krishna 的莲花足。
And all the elements of the material creation, the demigods, and the elements which the demigods preside over,They all worship Krishna's lotus feet.
半神人以及半神人们所统辖的元素，这些创造的元素，他们都崇拜 Krishna 的莲花足。
And they perform Vedic sacrifices and carry out Krishna's orders.
他们都举行韦达献祭，并且执行了他的命令。
And the self-satisfied, liberated sages also worship him with devotion.
那些自我满足了的、已经解脱了的圣人们也崇拜他，和分外崇拜他。
And they think of him as the supreme goal of life.
他们把他当作生命的至高无上的目标，总是想念他。
And the great devotees who are masters in bhakti yoga, they also worship his lotus feet with their pure hearts.
那些伟大的奉献者们，那些奉爱瑜伽的伟大的主人们，也用纯净的心意来崇拜他的莲花祖。
They worship him by hearing and chanting the glories of Krishna. For the most part, they worship him mentally.
这些解脱了的这些高尚的灵魂们，他们的崇拜大部分都是在他们的心意当中所崇拜的。
And only very rarely does Krishna give the opportunity to these demigods and devotees and great sages to meet him.
Krishna 极少，非常罕有的才能给予这些半神人、圣哲和奉献者们，能够让他们看见他自己。
But the gopis worship with Krishna is much more intimate.
但是勾皮们对 Krishna 的崇拜是比他们要亲密的多。
They're dancing with Krishna.
他们可以跟 Krishna 共舞。
Even before the rasa dance, even before the gopis go to dance, the gopis were already intimately familiar with Krishna.
甚至在 rasa 之舞举行之前，这些 gopi 们已经跟 Krishna 有着亲密的非常熟悉他，有着亲密的关系。
And at one point, Krishna left the gopis. At just at the beginning of the rasa dance, Krishna left them.
在 rasa 之舞开始的时候， Krishna 一度离开了这些 gopi 们。
So when Krishna left them, then the gopis were remembering the time they spent with Krishna.
当 Krishna 离开 gopi 之际，这些 gopi 们都在意念着他们跟 Krishna 共度的时光。
So they were experiencing the ecstasy of separation from Krishna.
这同，就是幸运女神崇拜的是同一对莲花组。
But the gopis understand these lotus feet in a very special way.
但是勾皮们是以一种特殊的方式去理解这对莲花组。
Because the gopis think of Krishna as the wonderful son of Nanda and Yashoda.
在勾皮的心目当中，他们是南德亚修达的可爱的儿郎的莲花组。
So the gopis would always hold the lotus feet of Krishna in their hearts. Even during the rasa dance, when they're dancing with Krishna, they would have his lotus feet in their heart.
甚至在勾皮们跟 Krishna 共跳 rasa 之舞的时候，他们也在内心紧紧地握着这对莲花组。
So because they are always holding the lotus feet of Krishna in their heart, they never felt they could overcome the pain of being separate from Krishna.
因为勾皮们总是在内心 握着 Krishna 的莲花足，如此他们才能够缓解与 Krishna 的分离之苦。
So the gopis are the greatest devotees because they worship Krishna's, they didn't just worship Krishna's feet by meditation.
Gopi 们是最了不起的奉献者，因为他们不是仅仅在冥想当中崇拜 Krishna 的莲花足。
The gopis actually held Krishna's lotus feet physically in their embrace. They embraced Krishna's lotus feet.
Gopi 们他们是实实在在的握着 Krishna 的莲花足，并且拥抱着这个莲花足。
The feet of Krishna are worshipped. This is the feet of the Supreme Lord in the form of Krishna.And the gopis worship them. So the gopis are superior to the demigods.
Gopi 们所崇拜的莲花足是至尊主以 Krishna 的形象出现的莲花足，所以 gopi 们他们要的地位要远远高于半世人马。
Because the gopis directly touch Krishna's lotus feet.So the gopis are superior to all the great sages.
Gopi 们因为在直接触碰了 Krishna 的莲花足，因为他，所以 gopi 们要远远超越那些圣人们。
And the gopis could hold Krishna's lotus feet to their chest, so they're superior to all the yogis.
Gopi 们。他们能够把 Krishna 的莲花足放在自己的胸口，所以他们也比那些瑜伽的大师们要优越。
And because the gopis associate with Krishna during the Rasa Lila, so the gopis are greater even than Mahalakshmi.
因为 gopi 们在 Rasa 的逍遥时光当中直接与 Krishna 联谊。所以他们甚至比 Mahalakshmi 还要高超。
So Uddhava describes how the gopis they got relief from their distress of separation from Krishna.
Uddhava 在此就描述了这些 gopi 们是如何摆脱、如何缓解他们的分离之苦。
This happened during the Rasa dance.
这个是在 Rasa 之舞当中所实现的。
So the separation the gopis suffer is much more serious.
Gopi 们所感受到的痛苦是更加严重的痛苦。
Not because now Krishna has left them to go to Mathura, so their separation is much more serious.
现在 Krishna 已经离开他们去了 Mathura, 这些 gopi 们的分离之苦就更加严重了。
And Uddhava, he wonders, because he brought a message from Krishna to give to the gopis, but he wonders if that is going to be sufficient.To pacify them.
因为 Uddhava 在替 Krishna 给这些牧牛姑娘捎信儿，所以他并不能肯定他，想知道这个能不能足以安慰牧牛姑娘们。
Well, Uddhava has tried his best to help the gopis.
Uddhava 是尽了最大的努力来帮助这些牧牛姑娘们。
But he doesn't think it will be enough to pacify them and to relieve them of their pain of separation.
但是他并不认为这能足以能够安抚他们的分离之苦。
But Uddhava is appreciative of the gopis that they're very, very great devotees.
Uddhava 非常非常欣赏这些牧牛姑娘，他认为她们是最伟大的奉献者。
And he appreciates the special love of Krishna which they have.
他也十分赞赏牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 的特殊的爱。
And that's why Uddhava has prayed to take birth in Vrindavan in any form of life.
由于这个原因, Uddhava 祈祷, 能够在文达文投生为任何的生命形式。
Even if it can be a plant or a bush, he just wants to be touched by the dust of the gopis' lotus feet.
即便是投生为一丛灌木或者是一株植物也好, 这样就能够得到Krishna莲花足下尘土的触碰。
So Uddhava, he understood the special love of the gopis which they have for Krishna.
Uddhava 能够理解这些牧牛姑娘所怀着的对 Krishna 的特殊的爱恋。
And that's why Krishna chose him to carry the message to the gopis.
由于这个原因, Krishna 挑选了Uddhava来给这些牧牛姑娘捎信儿。
So, just like Uddhava, Sukadeva Goswami also, had the same mood of the gopis, the mood of devotion to Krishna.
就像Uddhava,圣Sukadeva Goswami的内心也发展出这些牛姑娘对Krishna的奉爱之情。
Yeah. Sukadeva Goswami in the Srimad Bhagavatam, he praises Krishna's queens in Dwarka.
在圣殿伯加瓦坛的末尾，圣Sukadeva Goswami 赞扬了 Krishna 在Dwarka的皇后们。
He said, Sukadeva Goswami says, we cannot possibly describe the great austerities which these women performed. They perfectly served Krishna. Krishna who is the spiritual master of the universe. And these queens perfectly served him in pure love. They thought of him as their husband and they served him very intimately.
他们把Krishna当作自己的丈夫，他们以亲密的方式服务了他。They
would do things like massage his lotus feet.
他们会从事按摩他的莲花足这种活动。So
while speaking, the Sukadeva Goswami was actually thinking of the gopis of Braja.
说这番话的时候，圣Sukadeva Goswami实际上在想着Braja的那些女士们。But
he did not like to mention, he did not dare to mention the gopis, because he was afraid that in ecstasy he would lose control of himself.
但是他提及他们，因为他害怕在狂喜当中他会失去自制。We
know Sukadeva Goswami was afraid to even mention the name of Srimati Radharani.
我们知道Sukadeva Goswami 甚至没有提及 Srimati Radharani 的名字。
So even in the modern times, there are great devotees who have developed pure love for Krishna in the mood of the gopis.
甚至在当代，也有一些伟大的奉献者们，他们被认为已经发展了对Krishna的纯粹的爱。
So we shouldn't think the mood of the gopis is just for women. For men also, male devotees also can develop the mood of the gopis. Anybody who has read the scriptures will know the example of the great sages of the Dandakaranya forest.
任何读经典的人们都知道，丹达卡兰雅森林当中的那些圣人们。And
when these sages, when they saw Lord Ramachandra in the forest, they became attracted in conjugal love and wanted to enjoy him, as they wanted him to be their husband.
当这些圣人们 亲眼目睹主Ramachandra的美貌的时候，他们是被深深吸引了，他们就想发展出，就是想跟他一起享受，把他作为自己的丈夫。So
that's described by Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva told about that to his wife Parvati, described in Padma Purana.
这个事件，主Shiva在
Yeah. Lord Shiva said, when they saw Lord Hari in the beautiful form of Lord Ramachandra, they at once wanted to enjoy him. They were men, but they wanted to enjoy Lord Ramachandra in the mood of lovers. So the result was they took their next birth as women in Gokula.
结果就是在了他们的来世，他们投生为国库勒的女人们。And
the result was they got Krishna as their husband.
结果他们就获得了 Krishna 作为自己的丈夫。And
they got liberation from material existence.
他们就从物质存在当中获得了解脱。So
by performing austerities, the wise sons of Agni took birth as women.
通过从事苦行，火神阿格尼的那些聪明的儿子们，就投生为女人们。And
they got Lord Vasudeva as their husband.
他们获得了主Vasudeva为自己的丈夫。So
we see different examples, people, men, getting the conjugal loving relationship with Krishna in the mood of the gopis. So Uddhava said, I offer my respects again and again to the lotus feet of the women of Nanda Maharaj's village.
乌德巴说，我一再的顶拜南达大君的牧牛村庄的这些女人们的莲花族的尘土。When
the gopis loudly chant the glories of Krishna, the vibrations purify the three worlds.
当这些牧牛姑娘们 高声地唱诵着Krishna的荣耀的时候，这个音阵就净化了整个世界。So
in this way, Uddhava was getting great satisfaction, glorifying the gopis.
就这样，Uddhava通过荣耀那些牧牛姑娘们，他感到心满意足。And
Uddhava fell down on the ground, because that ground was the very path where the lotus feet of the gopis had walked.
就直挺挺的倒在了地上，因为这个道路呢是那些牧牛姑娘们的莲花族曾经触碰过的道路。
And he picked up some of the dust from the path and he placed it on his head.
他从地上又拾起了一些尘埃放在自己的头顶。
And he treated that dust like it was the greatest treasure in the universe.
他对待这些尘土的态度就好像他们是宇宙当中最稀罕的珍宝。
And then again he offered his obeisances, and then he offers a prayer.
随后他又再次献上顶拜，其后他开始背诵了祷文。
So Uddhava is in so much ecstasy, so much that he can see the gopis.
Uddhava 的狂喜之情是这样巨大，以至于他可以亲眼看见那些牧牛姑娘们。
He can see the gopis, and he speaks out and offers homage. He glorifies them.
自他亲眼看见牧牛姑娘的时候，他便开始荣耀了他们。
He glorifies them to the extent it's almost like they were not there, because when a person's there, you won't want to glorify them too much. But Uddhava, even though they're there, Uddhava is glorifying them like they were not there.
Uddhava 荣耀这些牧牛姑娘的时候，这个情景就好像牧牛姑娘不在他的眼前一样，因为倘若一个人就在自己的对面的时候，人就不会那么多的来荣耀他。但是Uddhava他荣耀这些牧牛姑娘的情景就好像牧牛姑娘就不在他的跟前。
He feels so much pleasure in chanting their names and chanting their glories, talking about them.
Uddhava, 当Uddhava唱诵牧牛姑娘的名字，还有荣耀他们的时候，他感到是这么的快乐。
But we should remember the highest kind of kirtan, sankirtan, the greatest sankirtan is that done by the gopis themselves.
我们应该明白，最高流的sankirtan, 齐颂圣名，是由这些牧牛姑娘亲自展示出来的。
And when the gopis do sankirtan, they sing the songs loudly and they purify the world.All the three worlds.
当这些牧牛姑娘从事桑提尔坦去送圣名的时候，她们的声音如此巨高声，以至于她们净化了所有三个世界。
Sukadeva Goswami had described that already when Uddhava had gone to visit Vrindavan.
当 Uddhava 去拜访 Vrindavan 的时候，圣苏格德高沙米已经对此做了描述。
The ladies of Braja sang about lotus-eyed Krishna. Their song blended with the sound of the churning of the milk.
他说 ，Braja 的这些女士们，她们唱颂着 Krishna 的荣耀，而她们的歌声和他们搅拌黄油、搅拌牛奶的声音混合在一起。
Because the gopis keeps working, they're doing all the chores, all the services they have to do as young women. They're not idle, they're busy taking care of the cows and churning the milk, but at the same time they're doing sankirtan, glorifying Krishna.
这些牧牛姑娘们并非在那里无所事事，他们忙着做家务事，他们会忙着搅拌牛奶，从事种种的活动。
So、because,
但是与此同时，他们在唱颂主的荣耀。
So because the gopis were doing this wonderful sankirtan, the sound vibration took away all the inauspiciousness in every direction. There was no inauspiciousness left. It was all purified by their kirtan.
当木牛姑娘从事着这些活动和唱歌的时候，他们驱散了四面八方的所有的不吉祥。
So any praise of the gopis, like the prayers which Uddhava had just given, that is also kirtan.
对勾品们，对木牛姑娘的任何赞美，就像 Uddhava 所刚刚吟诵的这些祷文，都属于 kirtan 的唱诵的范畴。
And that kind of kirtan will purify all the three worlds.
这种 kirtan, 这种唱诵会净化全世界。
Just like Uddhava did when he spoke this glorification of the gopis.
就像当 Uddhava 讲，荣耀 gopi 们所做的那样。
Okay, have we got, will we go on? Because we started very late.
Sati Madachi, 我们是继续讲呢，还是怎么办？因为我们开始的很晚。
Are there any questions here yet?
Here, there's only one question.By Shruti Rupa Devadasi,
okay. So let's do one more verse, a little bit more, and then we'll take the questions. So Uddhava says to the gopis, he says, what auspicious activities? What auspicious activities must that flute have performed to taste the nectar of Krishna's lips?
Uddhava 对那些木牛姑娘们说，啊，我亲爱的木牛姑娘们，这根笛子，它到底从事了什么样的吉祥活动，以至于它能够享受 Krishna 唇上的甘露呢？
And it leaves only when, because the flute is tasting the nectar from the lips of Krishna, it leaves only a taste for the gopis. But that nectar is actually meant for the gopis, it's not meant for the flute.
但实际上这个甘露本应该是由那些木牛姑娘品尝的，而不是由这根笛子品尝的。
But the bamboo trees, they're like the forefathers of the flute. And they're very happy. They shed tears of pleasure.
但是那些竹子，它们就好像是这根笛子的祖先一样，它们在他们留下了快乐的泪水。
His mother, the mother of the flute, is like the river on whose bank the bamboo was grown. The bamboo was born on the bank of the river, so the river is like the mother of the flute.
因为这根笛子，这根竹子是生长在河岸边，因此这条河流就好像这根笛子的母亲。
And so she's so happy to see her son tasting to see the flute tasting the nectar from Krishna's lips.
所以当她看见这根笛子品尝了 Krishna 唇上的甘露的时候，她是这么的喜悦。
So the lotus flowers which grow out from the river, they're standing erect, just like hairs are standing on straight on the body due to ecstasy.
在 河岸当中盛开的那些莲花们，就好像当河流狂喜的时候，它身上的毛发直竖一样。
So we were hearing Maharaj Parikshit was glorifying the gopis, but now he wants to glorify the best of the gopis, Srimati Radharani.
我们一直在聆听。Maharaj Parikshit, 他唱颂了那些勾皮们的牧牛姑娘的荣耀，接下来他就要把注意力专注在最了不起的牧牛姑娘 Srimati Radharani 身上。
And Srimati Radharani's love for Krishna is the highest that words cannot properly describe her love for Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 对 Krishna 的爱是最崇高的爱，没有任何言语能够充分地描述这份爱。
So Maharaj Parikshit is remembering, because these words are spoken by Maharaj Parikshit, so he's remembering Srimati Radharani, how she's always wanting to taste the nectar of Krishna's lips.
因为这番话是 Maharaj Parikshit 讲的，所以他一直在铭记着 Srimati Radharani 是总是恒常的渴望来品尝 Shri Krishna 莲花唇上的甘露。
And whenever Srimati Radharani would hear Krishna's flute from a distance, when Krishna would enter into the forest, then she would imagine the flute.She would think of that flute to be tasting the nectar.
当 Krishna 进入文达文森林的时候，当 Srimati Radharani 远远地听到 Krishna 的笛，她便在想象着这根笛子是怎样在品尝着 Krishna 莲花唇上的甘露的。
And when she would think like that, then she would envy the flute, like it was her rival in love.
当他有这个想法的时候，他便开始嫉妒起这根笛子来，就好像这根笛子呢是他的竞争的情侣对手一样。
And then the gopis would stand and they would talk about Krishna, and Srimati Radharani would interrupt them.
那些牧牛姑娘们，她在那儿站着，在相互谈论 Krishna 的时候 ，Srimati Radharani 就会打断他们。
She would interrupt them and she would talk of how that flute has no right to take the nectar of Krishna's lips because it belongs to her.
她便打断他们说，这根鼻子没有权利来品尝 Krishna。口中的甘露，唇上的甘露，因为这份甘露本来是属于他的。
So Srimati Radharani she has many friends with her, the gopis, and people like Lalita are there. And she asks Lalita, what good deeds did this flute do?
Srimati Radharani 有很多女友，其中一位是 Lalita。他便问这根笛子它到底做了什么善事呢？
This flute, it's lifeless, it's just a piece of wood. So what could it have done to get the blessing of enjoying Krishna's lips?
这根笛子不过是一根没有生命的木头罢了，它有什么权利来享受 Krishna 唇上的甘露？
If she could find out what the flute had done, then the gopis could also do it, and they could get the same favor.
如果他们能够发现这根笛子所做过的事情的话，姑娘们，她们也可以从事同样的活动，好得到同样的品味。
Because that nectar of Krishna's lips is meant for the gopis.
Krishna 呈上的甘露是本来是应该属于 Gopi 们母牛姑娘。
So Srimati Radharani, she only says that the nectar is theirs because she feels too shy to speak outright.
Srimati Radharani, 她只是说这个甘露是他们的，因为她太羞涩腼腆，不好她不好意思直截了当地说。
Yeah, she doesn't say it's theirs to enjoy. She just said it's theirs. When she's talking about the nectar from Krishna's lips, she doesn't say it's theirs to enjoy. She just said it's theirs. It belongs to the gopis.
当 Srimati Radharani 谈到 Krishna 唇上的甘露的时候，她并没有这么说，说这个甘露是由他们来品尝的。
So the flute may have, maybe it's okay for, it's all right for the flute to be in the hand of Lord Krishna. Or it could be held to Krishna's chest.
这根笛子呢，在 Krishna 的手中，这个是无可厚非的，在 Krishna 的Krishna 拿到他的胸口也无可厚非。
And even it can go to his lips, but the flute, it should not drink as much as he likes.
这根笛子甚至可以被放到 Krishna 的唇上，但是这根笛子不应该喝以这甘露喝的太多。
The flute should not be so bold.Because Srimati Radharani and the other gopis, they're all from the cowherd community and they have a close relationship with Krishna.
Because Srimati Radharani and her companions are from the cowherd community, they have a close relationship with Krishna.
So they have a right to get the nectar of Krishna's lips.
他们有权利得到 Krishna 唇上的甘露。
But the flute is an outsider. It's not from the not from the Vrindavan community. It's an outsider.
这根笛子不过是个外人罢了，它并不属于牧牛郎的社团。
And if the flute continues to drink that nectar of Krishna's lips.Then the gopis will have to steal him away from Krishna. And they'll take that flute to a secret place, keep it safe. Because if they don't do that, the flute will take all the nectar himself, and we will leave only a few remnants for the gopis.
如果他们不这么做的话，这根笛子就会独享 Krishna 唇上的甘露，只给 gopi 们牛姑娘留下这个一点点鲫鱼。
So the river is like the flute's mother.Because the water enables the bamboo to grow.
河流就好像笛子的母亲，因为它滋养这个笛子竹子，使得它们生长。
And the flute is made from these bamboo trees which grow there at the side of the river.
由于这个竹子生长在河岸。所以他们才能生长。
So when the rivers think about their son, the flute, how it's so successful, they feel very proud.
当这河流，他 他们一想到他们生长在他们岸边的儿子的时候，他们就感到内心充斥着自豪感。
And so the lotus flowers which grow there, they stand on end, just like the hairs on the body stand on end.
这样呢，在河中盛开的这些莲花就直挺挺的，伫立在那里，就好像。当人快乐的时候，他们会毛发直竖。
And these bamboo trees, they're so proud of their son that they shed tears in the form of sweet sap, which falls from the bamboo.
当竹子们，他们也想到为他们的。后代而感到自豪的时候，他们禁不住流下了泪水。这个泪水就是以竹子身上留下的甜蜜的汁液的形式而呈现出来。
And their skin erupts, just they get like bumps on their skin, and they cry, like the elders in a family.When one of their children become a servant of the personality of Godhead.
这些竹子的身上，就隆起了一些，就疙瘩，这就好像是那些鸡皮疙瘩一样，而且他们流出了大量的泪水，就好像一个家族当中的长辈们。看到他们的孩子成为了人格神手的仆人的感受一样。
Okay, we'll stop there today.
那好，那我们今天的正课部分就到这里。接下来回答问题。第一个问题是，Shruti Rupa Devadasi 顶拜 Guru 们。顶拜咕噜和老师们，有新人提问，和非常功利性的非奉献者密切接触相处久了，总是做梦被毒蛇缠身，让自己的心意和情绪非常受打扰。请问咕噜，这是否是 Krishna 的警告呢？还有自己应该怎么做才能让非奉献者受到自己的灵性影响，而不是再继续被他们影响呢？Obeisance to Guru and teachers, some new faculty raised the questions that when they get too close with those non-devotees, those karmi, they will dream in the night that the poison snake will wrap around their bodies. Their mind and their emotion are very much disturbed. So the new body asked Guru, is this a warning from Krishna?
Yes.
Also, what should they do that they will not be influenced by non-devotee, but instead influence non-devotee?
Yes, this is a sign from Krishna that you have to be careful in the association of non-devotees.
是的，这个是 Krishna 的一个警告，就是在和非奉献者联姻的时候要小心。
What should we do to so we don't get influenced by non-devotees? We should take shelter of Krishna, chant his holy name, and preach his glories.To the non-devotees.
那我们应该怎么办呢？我们不应当受到他们的影响，我们应当脱离于 Krishna， 唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，向非奉献者传播 Krishna 的荣耀。
Whenever we're in danger from bad association, we have to hold on to Krishna, take shelter of Krishna.
当我们由于不良的联谊而处在危险的境地的时候，就应该脱离 Krishna，
We have to call out to Krishna to save us from the material energy. Association with the non-devotees is very dangerous, very, very dangerous. It's a very dangerous situation. So you should be very careful to try to avoid the association of non-devotees.
和非奉献者联谊是非常危险的处境，应当小心避免非奉献者的联谊。
Of course, wherever we go, there will be people non-devotees, and you have to mix with them, but don't be intimate with them.
当然，无论我们去哪里，都会有非奉献者的人们，但是呢，不要和他们。
Don't eat their food.
不要吃他们的食物。
You have to remember, these people are not devotees and they have a lot of karma.
要牢记，这些人他们是非奉献者。
So you have to just simply be polite with them and at the same time don't get too close to them. Don't get too close. Haribol? Gurumani? Gurumani. Haribol. Hare Krishna. Krishna Kumari.
Hare Krishna, Gurudev.
Yeah. 我能听见您的声音。 Sati Zainali.
Gurumani 好像信号不好。
Oh, Sati, Sati 的问题。 Ah, ma'am, 那个是。 Gurumani the one thing, Bushwa the one thing.
是的, Gurumani, 能听见我的声音吗? Haribol.
Krishna, 哎呀, 那么多倒霉啊。
今天考验好多。
真的。 Gurumani, Nihui Lama. Oh, yeah. Gurumani, Krishna Kumari, Nihai Zaima.
What's that? Shut down, Guru. 他举手了。妈妈，你。哦，挂了一个号，可以等等。
说话，好了不？
Hare Krishna.
Haribol Sati.
Gurudev. 我联络 Guru Mani Madanji 了，他的网络他也不知道是什么原因，他在线，但是发不出声音来，再让他重新登录一下试试。
好，我们等他。
Hare Krishna， 能听见吗？
听到了，哈利波回来了。
哈利波 ，Hare Krishna。那个 Sati， 我现在已经一个问题都看不见，
一个问题都。
稍等，我给你发啊。
好的。你说你读也行。刚才说到了这个跟非奉献者联谊，刚才说到了
第二个问题吗？不对，稍等啊，第二个是 Runa 的问题
啊，
发过去了
啊，对对 ，Runa 的问题 ，Runa 的问题。
看见了吗？
哦，没有看见，没有。
哇，我这手机也倒了，点不出去了。今天好神奇。
哦，我瞎马，那我先读下一个问题吧。瞎马，对。看到的是啊，对 ，Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj。啊，看见了，这是 Yuna 的是吧 ？Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisance. Oh Lord Vishnu Prabhupada. First, how can a person with anarthas, who is not a pure devotee, take refuge with Krishna? Because one cannot be free from anartha instantly. Will Krishna give shelter to such a person?And what is the proper way to approach him? Thank you. 云娜的问题，他说，一个有阿那塔的人，他不是纯粹奉献者，这样的人怎么能脱离 Krishna 呢？他首先是，顶拜 Guru 和奉献者，然后他就说，因为人不能立刻摆脱阿那塔， Krishna 能不能给这样的一个人庇护呢？接近 Krishna 的正确方法是什么呢？非常感谢 Guru。
Okay, 方法 the process of approaching Krishna, you have to approach him through his devotees. You have to approach through the devotees. You don't go directly to Krishna, but you approach Krishna through his pure devotees.
这个方法就是要透过奉献者。透过奉献者来接近 Krishna， 而不是直接接近 Krishna。通过 Krishna 纯粹奉献者。
Of course, we know in the beginning we're not pure, and our chanting and our service to Krishna is not going to be pure. But by serving Krishna, we become purified.
我们知道呢，我们一开始是不纯洁的。我们的念诵不纯洁，我们的服务不纯洁，但是通过服务 Krishna， 我们就能得到净化。
And by contacting Krishna more and more through service, gradually our service will become pure.
通过跟 Krishna 的接触，通过越来越多的服务。我们就能够得到净化了。
So we have to continually associate and approach Krishna. We have to do service, chant his holy name and hear about Krishna, glorify Krishna. And by contacting Krishna more and more, just like you put the metal bar in the fire, gradually it becomes hotter and hotter, like the fire. takes on all the qualities, heat and light, like the fire. So we have to keep on contacting Krishna, and we will also become pure, like Krishna.
我们继续联谊，继续跟Krishna接触Krishna，继续多唱诵他的名字，继续聆听Krishna的荣耀。通过这种不断的接触，逐渐的就像接触火的时候，我就会越来越热，有越来越多热量越来越高，光芒就越来越大。通过接触Krishna，这样就会像Krishna那样的净化、纯净。
Yeah, okay, Shaigamanti.
下一个是, nowhere does it say how Lakshmi reacted when she failed Gurudev. Tell us more about that. 第二个问题是, 没有能够进入到 Ratha 之舞的时候, 她的反应是什么? 她是不是内心不安, 或者是生气了? Gurudev 能不能告诉我们?
No, she would... She's a pure devotee. You have to understand, she's eternally the consort of the Supreme Lord. So she doesn't get envious. She didn't get angry.
Lakshmi是纯粹的奉献者，她是至尊主的永恒的伴侣，所以她没有嫉妒，她不嫉妒，她也不生气。
Krishna gave her another service. He told her that she would reside eternally on his chest. There are some lines on the chest of Krishna, and these are the lines. Lakshmi, she resides there eternally for his service.
就在Krishna的胸膛上面有一道线，然后这根线呢是Lakshmi，她就是这样永恒的住在 Krishna的胸口来服务他。 下一个是谁的问题不知道，顶拜Guru，为什么大部分解脱了的灵魂都在心里崇拜 Krishna 呢？ Obeisance to Guru, why most liberated soul worship Krishna in their heart?
Because they worship Krishna in their heart. We're pointing out the gopis, they directly worship Krishna, physically. But other people, we don't have that opportunity to directly worship Krishna, to be with Krishna like the gopis. So we keep him in our heart.
在课里头就讲到了这些gopi们，他们是直接在崇拜 Krishna， 他们亲身的崇拜 Krishna， 而别的人没有这个机会，所以他们不能像gopi那样直接崇拜，他们就在心里的崇拜。Yeah,
just like you may love someone and you have the opportunity, you like to be with them physically, but when they're not there, when they're away from you, then you think of them in your mind.
就像你爱某人的话，那个人他不能跟你亲身在一起，他离你有一段距离，相隔遥远，那你又特别思念他，你只能在心里头来想念他，崇拜他。Yes. 下一个问题，不知道是谁的。 我也不知道这个问题是谁的。 Shruti Rupa， 另外请教Guru， 既然 Krishna 从来没有离开过 Vrindavan， 为什么还要派 Uddhava 去送信儿呢？眼睁睁看着亚瑟的母亲和那么多物流姑娘处于痛苦的思念，还不直接自己面对他们。Shruti Rupa asked that since Krishna never leave Vrindavan, why he send Uddhava to send message to the gopis and witness Mother Yashoda and so many gopis sink into the suffer the pain suffer the pain of remembered Krishna. Why Krishna don't face them directly?
Yes, you have to understand when we say Krishna never leaves Vrindavan, it means he was there, but initially he was manifest. He was there metaphysically, but then when he never leaves Vrindavan, he's there in the unmanifest form.
So, 之所以说 Krishna 从来没有离开 Vrindavan 是这样的，就是一开始 Krishna 是以展示的形象，他亲身在 Vrindavan， 后来他以不展示的形体从来没有离开 Vrindavan。
The gopis they saw Krishna go, they saw Akrura came and he took Krishna and Balaram away with him, they went to Mathura. So the gopis, they thought that Krishna was leaving them.
Gopis 们看见 Akura, 眼睁睁地看着 Akura 过来，把 Krishna 和 Balarama 带到 Mathura 的时候，他们以为 Krishna 离开了他们。
So the gopis are thinking Krishna has gone from this allowed them to feel more love for Krishna. Their love for Krishna increased by Krishna going away from Vrindavan. So Krishna enacted this, although we say Krishna never leaves Vrindavan, it's true. He's there in the unmanifest form in Vrindavan. So that increases, the gopis, they feel the separation from Krishna. They feel more love for Krishna in his absence.
Krishna, 之所以说 Krishna 从不离开 Vrindavan， 是因为 Krishna 他也以他不展示的形象，在 Vrindavan， 而那些牧牛姑娘的时候，他们在与 Krishna 分离当中呢，他们就更爱 Krishna 了。The next one?
Yeah.
第二个应该怎么理解 Krishna 总会在不同的宇宙不同的时间上演同样的消失光呢？难道天堂和地狱也有它同样的逍遥活动吗？这些都是灵性世界的投影吗？答案不。
Guru Mani? Guru Mani? Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Oh, 你回来了。Guru Mani, 回来了吗？
Hare Krishna, did you hear? Yes, Hare Krishna. Oh, Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare
Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Guru Mani.
Hare Krishna. Yes, Maharaj, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Hare Krishna. Yes, I don't know what happened today.
Okay.
I tried to Jishu. Log in another phone.
Jishu, one
more. Yeah, okay. Shruti Rupa Manasi asked, how can we understand that Krishna will enact the same Leela in various universes at the same time? How can we understand this point?
Well, you have to understand Krishna has inconceivable powers. Just like he's appearing and he's expanded in the heart of every living entity as a super soul. So he's everywhere, in everything. So he can be in every universe and he can be performing his pastimes.
Liu Yiping asked that the obeisance to Guru was the symptom of the most elevated love. What's the symptom of that?
The symptom of the most elevated love is that you sacrifice everything for the other person. You won't think about your own benefit. You think only about the other person.
会为了别人而牺牲一切，不考虑自己的好处，只考虑对方、别人。
Just like in the Shikshastikam, the last verse of the Shikshastikam, that is the highest love.
就像在八训规当中的最后一个诗节，这个就是描述了什么是最崇高的爱。
Srimati Radharani says, if my unhappiness makes you happy, that is my happiness.
Srimati Radharani said, 如果我的不快乐导致了你的快乐，那这就是我的快乐。
Okay, Shai Gawanti.
下一个问题。 Shamsaki, Hare Krishna, 顶拜Guru和奉献者们, 蜗牛姑娘对 Krishna 的嫉妒是超然的, 是他们认为 Krishna 应该把更多的时间留给和他们爱的交流, 而不是大部分时间用来吹走他的名字, 我这样理解对吗? 所以对 Krishna和蜗牛姑娘之间这种纯洁的爱恋, 常常被世人所误解是吗? 再次顶拜你。
Shyamasaki said that Hare Krishna obeys the Guru and devotees. The gopis, envious to that roots of Krishna is transcendental enviness. They think that Krishna should give more time to exchange love with them, most of the time, Krishna will play his flute. Is this understanding right?
Yes, right.
是的，这是正确的。Therefore, the Krishna's loving affair with the gopis, their pure love between Krishna and gopis, often will be misunderstood by the mundane people. Is that right?
Yeah, yes.
是的，您说的都是正确的。
People don't understand the pure love of the gopis.
世人并不能理解，公牛姑娘的纯洁无瑕的爱。
Okay.
The next. Sorry. The next one.
Yeah.
OK， 下一个问题是妙音，请拜莲花组的，请拜所有的奉献者。有时候跟奉献者连以后，第二天念诵的时候心意杂念很多，不能专注，这是什么原因呢？该怎么办呢？妙音 Mataji paid obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, and she said that sometimes after the association with devotees, the next morning when she chants.There are a lot of other thoughts in the mind cannot be very attentive to the japa. So what's the reason for that? What should she do?
Well, you should chant more and chant louder.
这个办法就是更多的念诵。声音更大声的来念诵。
Pray to Krishna to help you control your mind.
向 Krishna 祈祷，请 Krishna 帮助你来控制你的心意。Hare Krishna, the next one.
Yeah.
下一个是来自于古人的 Hare Krishna, 顶外 Guru 的莲花族和所有的奉献者，请问 Lakshmi 都有哪些象征呢？财富专指金钱吗？住在主的胸膛啊。So this question is raised by 普人 obeisance to Guru's lotus feet and all devotees. My question is that what's thesymptom of Lakshmi. Which are the symptoms of Lakshmi? Does wealth refer to money? And Lakshmi reside on the chest of the Lord.
What is that a question? Lakshmi resides on the chest of the Lord. What's that? I don't understand what the.
Yes, the question is that what are the symptoms of Lakshmi?
But what's the last part about? Lakshmi resides on the chest.
The question didn't finish. It's only the question only state that the second part is that the Lakshmi reside on the chest of the Lord, but it didn't finish the whole sentence, only the part of the sentence.
Okay. So what are the symptoms of Lakshmi? Well,She's the consort of the Supreme Lord, and she massages the lotus feet of the Lord. She gives service to the Lord, whatever the Lord desires. She's a servant.
Lakshmi 的象征是什么呢？就是她是至尊主的伴侣，她会给主的足按摩， 他服务主，无论主居住在哪里，他就在那里为主按摩，他是主的仆人。
And she also desires to get the favor of the Lord.
她也渴望得到主的仁慈。
She went to Vrindavan to do a. She resides eternally in Vrindavan.
Lakshmi 甚至去 Vrindavan 去了 Vrindavan， 她渴望能永远的居住在 Vrindavan。
Her desire was to join the Rasa dance, but she did not get that opportunity.
Lakshmi 她本来是想加入 Rasa 之舞的，但是 Lakshmi 没能得到这个机会。
Yeah.
So that's all the questions here. Krishna Kumari 还有别的问题吗？我这里只有这些所有了。
有，他后面补充了一个问题，看见吗？说住在主的胸膛怎样理解？住在主的胸膛怎样理解？
哦，
还有学习经典只听不讲，
哦，
会提升知觉吗？
Continued with the second part of the question that resides on the chest of the Lord.
Yeah, what's the question? Guru Mani, Nizaima.Guru Mani, we are thinking about our need to show you.
Hare Krishna.
Ah, Hare Bo.
Hare Bo. Can you hear? Now, she continued to ask how to understand that Lakshmi resides on the chest of the Lord.
Well, how to understand? Just like the Lord, we see him laying on his Anantashesha, right? He has a bed of Anantashesha. Anantashesha is his bed. He lays there on his bed of that celestial serpent, Anantashesha. And when he lays there on his bed, then Lakshmi lays on his chest.
Lakshmi lays on the Lord's chest. Okay. 就是我们看到有那个图片，就主啊躺在那个蛇床上，他的床是 Anantashesha， 是天蛇，主就躺在这个蛇床上，然后 Lakshmi 呢，他的位置呢，他就住在主的胸。She also lay down on the chest of the Lord.
Yes.
And that. Okay. 那 Lakshmi 呢？他就躺在主的胸膛上。
Of course, sometimes she will also massage his lotus feet.
有的时候 Lakshmi 他也按摩主的莲花足。
And she makes all arrangements for the Lord's service, to bring his meals, to bring his food, and take care of all of his comforts. She will do all of this. She will look after him in Vaikuntha to keep him very comfortable. Hare Krishna, Guru Mani, Nidaima.
Krishna.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes.
你没有给我们翻译。
那个Lakshmi 呢，他就是有的时候他是躺在主的胸口，当然有的时候呢他也离开主的胸口，他就在坐在主的足下，然后按摩主的双足。
And she's busy taking care of all of his needs. Make sure he gets nice food and everything. All his comforts taken care of.
他也就是忙着来满足主的各种需求，他会就是设法让，他会设法呢，他还给主食物，准备食物，还让主他还让主呢就是感到非常舒适，就会他会安顿，让主感到非常舒适，照顾他所有的需求。The next part of the third part.
仆人说，财富专指金钱吗？
The 仆人 asked that, the wealth, does wealth refer specifically money?
Well, in the spiritual world, it doesn't refer to money.
在灵性世界，财富不是专指金钱。
Even in the material world, there's different kinds of wealth. Just like for a farmer, water is very important. He needs water to produce his crops. 하리보 Guru Mani.Guru Mani, Haribo. Krishna Kumari, you can tell in Sima.
Danakeli-san,
好。
Hare Krishna,
Maharaj.
Please accept
my
humble obeisances.
Hare Krishna, Danakeli Maharaj, my humble obeisances, all glories to Prabhupada. Thank you.
So,
thank you very
Krishna,
much.
Maharaj, shall I translate what you said just now?
Yeah, please.
就刚才哈克什呢，亲爱的大家，就刚才妈说的意思呢，就是说，如果是对于农夫来说，他的财富就是水，因为他需要水来种植他的谷物。
And wealth for devotees, just like brahmanas, the special wealth is peace of mind.
那比如说，对于奉献者，比如说像这个，brahmanas, 婆罗门。他的这个财富就是平静的内心。
So we can see wealth can come in many different ways for different people depending on their situation.
所以说呢，在不同的情况下，我们可以看到这个财富是以各种各样的形式来展现的。
Hare Krishna. Okay, 还有问题吗？
Kumani, 那个 Krishna Kumar 吗？请你看还有什么别的问题吗？
看一下。仆人第三个问题，学习经典只听不讲，会提升自觉吗？
Okay, the third question from 仆人 is that when we study the sastras, if we only listening to the sastras but don't try to explain or give the lecture on the sastras, will that also make us to learn anything?
Well, it depends. Certainly, a good way to test our understanding, how much we've actually understood what we've heard, is by explaining it to others.
那这个要取决于具体的情况了。就如果我们最好的方法来考验我们是不是学到了这个知识，就是要把我们学到的知识向其他的人去解释。
We may think we've understood something, but when we try to explain it to other people, we find it difficult.
我们也许可能觉得我们是理解了一些知识，但是当我们试着要把这些知识去向别人去进行解释的时候，我们发现其实我们是解释不清楚的。
So it certainly helps us to improve our realization and understanding of a topic when we have to explain it again.
那所以说呢，如果要是我们把我们学到的知识试着把它解释出来的话呢，这毫无疑问是能够帮助我们能够更好的去理解我们所学到的知识的。
We may hear and we just forget everything we heard.
而且呢，我们也许可能听完了以后呢，就把我们所听到的东西都给忘记了。
So it's important for us to also use what we've heard.
而且呢，我们也很重要的一点呢，就是去运用我们所听到的这些知识。
So it's a good practice to try to explain everything we've heard.
所以说我们要是去努力的去践行去实践我们所学到的这个东西，这对于我们来说是一个非常好的习练的方法。
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So let me see. Yeah, there are questions I see from
Gita Govinda.
我看看在哪儿啊， Gita Govinda Manji 的问题在哪里呢？哦，看到了。阿尔克什纳迪拜咕噜及所有的奉献者们，请问作为我们如何崇拜主的莲花族呢？无法理解。阿尔克什纳 ，please accept my very humble obeisances to you, Guru Maharaj, and all the devotees. My question is that how to worship the lotus feet of the Lord? I cannot understand that.
Well, the process of approaching the superior personality is to first of all approach them from the lotus feet. You look down at their feet. And we begin to approach them from the lotus feet.
就是当我们再去接近至尊主的时候，我们首先接近的是他的莲花足，就是我们是从至尊主的莲花足开始看起的，是从脚下开始往上看的。
We shouldn't look directly onto the face of the Lord, but we must worship the lotus feet and then progress up.
所以呢，我们不能够直接去看主的脸庞，那我们要先从主的莲花足开始看起，这样的一点点的往上看。
So worshipping the lotus feet also encourages the humility that helps us to keep the humble attitude and reminds us we're approaching superior personality.
而且呢，我们去崇拜主的莲花足，也是让我们处在一个谦卑的这种心绪之下，让我们知道我们是在接近一位非常的伟大的人物。
Actually, there's no difference between the Lord's lotus feet and His lotus face. The Lord is absolute.
但事实上呢，至尊主的莲花足和他的莲花脸之间是没有任何的区别的，主他是绝对的。
But the process of first of all approaching His lotus feet is encouraged to remind us of the supreme position of the Lord, that we're approaching the greatest personality and we want to give Him the greatest respect.
但是呢，当我们去接近主的莲花族的时候呢，这其实也是鼓励着我们，让我们了解我们是在接近一位非常伟大的人物。然后呢，我们通过接近他的莲花族，以这样的方式来给这个伟大的人物以完全的尊敬之情。
OK.
Yeah, Marge. 下面一个问题是。Shruti Rupa Maji 的问题，再请教 Guru， 每天都感觉 Krishna 给我们设置很多的考试，回到灵性世界以后还会不会有这么多的考试考不完的事呢？怎样才能理解考试及及格了呢？ Guru Maji， I have one more question to ask you, because every day we feel that we have been placed in all kinds of tests by Lord Krishna. If we go back to the spiritual world, are we still need to go through those endless tests, and what is sign to say we have been passed that those tests? How to pass those tests?
How to pass those tests? Well, these tests are given to us to help us to improve or to increase our attachment and devotion to Lord Krishna.
那么所有的这些试炼呢，其实全部都是让我们能够更加加深对 Sri Krishna 的莲花族的庇护和依附。
And when you go back to Godhead, you could imagine that there is some kind of test, because in the sense that every day Krishna goes out to the forest, so the gopis are tested, their separation from Krishna is a test.
那么回到灵性世界以后呢，其实从某种意义上来说还是要接受考验的，因为主 Krishna 他每天都会去到森林里面，那么他当到森林里面去放牧乳牛的时候呢，其实对于 Gopi 们来说也就是来考验他们要和 Sri Krishna 处于分离之情的这种状态之中。
Of course there are no demons in the spiritual world.
那么当然在灵性世界是没有恶魔的。
But there's the rumors, have rumors of demons.
但是呢，在灵性世界总是会有这样的谣言，谣言就说会有恶魔来了。
So, you know, we may consider that the test is actually only in our mind. It's not really a test. It's all just pastimes.And these pastimes are just there to increase our love for Krishna.
但事实上呢，就是这个我们可以理解，就所有的这些试炼全部都是在我们的内心之中，是我们的心意。这个没有真正的外在情况来讲，实际上是没有真正的试验的。这个试炼它其实就是要让我们在不断的去加深对 Sri Krishna 的依恋，对 Sri Krishna 的爱。
Yeah, you're thinking test. Krishna is not giving a test. Krishna is just helping us to love him.
我们在想着我们在考试，但其实呢 ，Krishna 他其实并没有让我们在处于考试的状态。Krishna 他不过是在帮助我们能够更去爱他。
It's our ignorance, our illusion. We're thinking it's a test, you know.
但是呢，如果我们要是觉得我们是在为考试的话呢，其实我们是处在一种愚昧的物质之中，就虚幻觉之中。
Krishna doesn't reject anyone. Krishna doesn't fail anyone. Nobody fails.
Krishna 他其实不会放弃任何一个人的，也没有任何一个人会考不过这个试。
There's no failure in devotional service. Somebody's trying to do the service for Krishna. There's no question of failure.
那在做奉爱服务的这个过程中其实是没有失败这一说的，如果某一个人他想为 Sri Krishna 做奉爱服务，那他就是能做的，不会有失败这件事儿。
Yeah, 下一个问题。
Marsh, that's everything.
Oh, okay, very good. So thank you so much, Dana Kelly. It's so nice to hear your voice.
Thank you so much, Marsh.
Hare Krishna.我们感谢所有的奉献者聆听，感谢 Guru Mani 还有 Dana Kelly 今天早上有两个人给我们翻译， 感谢所有的奉献者聆听提问，我们祝福你们长存快乐，万事如意，传教顺利，舍利普拉帕提斋。